So, here I'm Nikesh, and we are going to see the comparative analysis of Brazil and India in the 10th standard geography SSC. And here we go with the second chapter, location and extent. In this year, we'll have some introduction about the chapters and overall outlook of the portion, how they are different from one another, and how they are been similar, that we are going to see. Initially, the geography subject is been made a comparative study of India and Brazil. The comparative study is made of India and Brazil because both of them are developing countries, and developing countries are having many similarities between them. So as far as that point is concerned, the government has taken, or the state government has taken this step to make a study of comparative analysis of India and Brazil. So second chapter deals with the location and extent of the Brazil, and how they are, Brazil and India I would say, and how they are differentiated, and how they have been located in different hemisphere, what are their latitude, what are their longitude, and how they will be facing the seasons. In the preceding chapter we are going to see the seasons, and how they are initially, we are going to see who ruled them, and what kind of similarities are there, or what kind of government they have in their country. So we will start with the second chapter of geography, location and extent. Location and extent, initially what we have to understand, we will take an introduction of both the country of Brazil and India. First of all, we will go with the India. We will take the background of both the countries, what kind of things have been different and what kind of things have been similar in both the country we are going to see. And this is how we are going to start. We will first start with India. How India developed over the period of time, what all crisis does India face over the period of time, and what is the present situation, and how the things are going to be, we will see in this chapter. And here we go with the India. So how we are going to see, first what we are going to see, India, location and extent. First of all, we are going to see India. India was ruled by the Britishes. And after that, India got independence in 1947, particularly we will say 15th August. This flowchart may be useful for all of you. So if you want, you can just note it down, 1947. And then after, we got independence and we established a federal system in which parliamentary system was established, and India got independence in 1947, 15th August. Federal system was established, and which is known as parliamentary system, in which the prime minister, is the head of the nation. For example, present prime minister of India is Shri Narendra Modi. So he is the head of our country in a parliamentary democracy. Understanding everybody? So this is how the things are going to be. Initially, we will see how India came over the period of time, and how India got independent. So here is the federal system. And after that, after the 1947, we say, okay, after 1947, we had to face many wars. India had faced many wars. For example, in 1971, 65, Kargil. Generally, we faced three wars. And there were initially many crises in India. So over the period of time, India overcome all the crises, and this is how the things are going to be in the future, that we are always we would keep ourselves as a motivating, and we would keep ourselves the country developing. And we are going to see the Brazil system as of now. Brazil was under the Portuguese rule. Similarly, India got independent, Brazil also got independent. Brazil got independent in 1822. It got independent in 1822. They are also having a federal system of parliamentary, but it is having the head as a presidential democracy. Presidential democracy has been established, where president is the head. President is the head. So in India, the difference between both the countries are, India was under the British rule, they were under the Portuguese rule. India got independence in 1947, they got independence in 1822. India had a federal system, they are also having federal system. Here we have Prime Minister as the head, and here they have President as the head. Over the period of time, what we can understand is that India and Brazil are having similar thing, but they were India were ruled by British and they were ruled by the Portuguese. Initially, they got independence in 1822, but they had to face many crises over the period of time. Brazil, I am talking about. They have the presidential democracy and we have the prime ministerial democracy. And over the period of time, Brazil, there were many famines due to harsh climatic condition in Brazil. So over the period of time, how Brazil overcome this crisis and how they dealt with it, we are going to see. So we will see the location and extent. For example, location and extent, we are going to see location and extent. It refers to the latitude and longitude and hemisphere, northern, eastern, western. We will start with the chapters how the things are going to be. Initially, we are having main four directions. Main four directions means what? Generally, four major directions. This is the north, this is the south, this is the east, and this is the west. These are the four major directions. And over the period of time, there are four sub-directions. This is northeast, southeast, northwest, and this is southwest. Over the period of time, we have evolved with the eighth direction: north, south, east, west, northeast, southeast, southwest, and northwest. Over the period of time, similarly, we will say we are going to see if there are hemispheral divisions of the earth. Hemispheral divisions means what? When there is a division vertically or horizontally, there have been certain part being made of a globe. For example, if you are going to see a division is made as shown over here. When the things are divided in upper part and lower part, then we are going to see this is as a north and this is as a south. So this part is northern hemisphere and this part is known as southern hemisphere. This part is northern hemisphere and this part is southern hemisphere. When the division go vertically, then it would be like eastern hemisphere and this would be the western hemisphere. Similarly, India and Brazil are located in particular hemisphere, so that we are going to see. So it would be like, see, India is nothing but having a shape. For example, this is the globe and this is the equator passing, and if you are going to see, this is the 0° meridian. So initially, before starting the 0° meridian and all those stuffs, I would make you understand what is latitude and what is longitude. Latitude and longitude over the period of time. See, latitude, the word latitude means what? Latitude means लेटा हुआ लाइन. फॉर इजी अंडरस्टैंडिंग, जो लेटा हुआ है वो लैटिट्यूड है. तो ऑब्वियसली लेटा हुआ लैटिट्यूड हुआ तो जो खड़ा रहेगा वो क्या रहेगा? लॉन्गिट्यूड. इट विल बी इजी फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट, हाउ, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द लैटिट्यूड एंड व्हाट इज द लैटिट्यूड एंड व्हाट इज द लॉन्गिट्यूड ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सी, लेटा हुआ मीन्स लैटिट्यूड. लैटिट्यूड मीन्स वॉट? ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सी, लैटिट्यूड, देर विल बी 0° इक्वेटर, द पार्ट विच इमेजिनरी लाइन विच डिवाइड द अर्थ इन टू इक्वल पार्ट in the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, that is known as 0° equator. The line, imaginary line, will divide into two equal part, north and south, that is known as equator. So equator is 0° and the latitude starts from the equator. So if the imaginary line, it is starting towards the north. For example, if you are making a line from 0° towards the north, so it will be starting at 0 and it will be ending at 90°. So similarly, if we are starting from towards the south, then it will be like 0 0 and it will be ending at 90. So total latitude 90 over here and 90 over here is like 180°. Total latitudinal measure is 180°. And over the period of time, if you are going to see the longitude, as I said, if leta is latitude and the vertical would be the longitude. If you are going to see the longitude will be the standing line. Longitude will be the standing line. Standing line as if like this. If you are going to see the standing line will be of two part, of the eastern hemisphere and will be of the western hemisphere. Eastern hemisphere, it will be starting like this. The globe will be starting 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. And here the part will be coming to, what you would say, 180 degree. From here to there, 180 degree. 180 degree east, and starting from west side, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40. So it will be going and having a total of 180 degree west. So total longitude will be summing to 360 degree, but latitude will be having only 90, it will be 180, but longitude will be like 180 here and 180 here. Total it will be the sum of 360 degree. So where is India located? Where is Brazil located? We are going to see in this latitude and longitudinal wise. So first of all, see, for example, India is nothing but a triangular kind of thing, tapering towards the north and tapering towards the south, both of them. And kind of thing, a triangle over here too. So for the better understanding, I would say. So it was as if like top sea. So there are three major latitude passing through the total globe, I would say. First of all, we are going to see, for example, if this is the whole globe, then it would be like the equator 0 degree. Then other latitude passing is towards the northern side is as of like Tropic of Cancer, as we say, and here it is the Tropic of Capricorn passing towards the south. The degree measures are being there. I will make you study how the degree measures are being there for the parallel of Tropic of Cancer, equator, and Tropic of Capricorn. The notes will be provided in PDF will be just given to you, and you will have to just refer and how the things will be. So as if like this is the 0 degree, so 23 degree 30 minutes, so 23 degree 30 minutes north, it is the Tropic of Cancer, and 23 degree 30 south is Tropic of Capricorn, and 0 degree is equator. So as if like this, we are going to see the 23-30 north is going to be the Tropic of Cancer, and 23-30 south is going to be the Tropic of Capricorn. So basically these are the three major latitude we are going to see, and how the things are going to be, and how India is, where India is located, we are going to see. I told you that it's like India's shape is like tapering towards the north and south, and a small triangle over to the northeast. If you are going to see, India is somewhat located, if we draw a globe or kind of thing, then it is as if like India is located, this is the eastern hemisphere, so this is the eastern hemisphere, total, and it is located in eastern hemisphere, we understood, and towards the northern part, so this is the north. So India is located in the northeastern part of the hemisphere. India is located in the northeastern part of the hemisphere. So as if like we can understand, India is located above the equator, so northern hemisphere, and towards the right side of the 0 degree prime meridian, so therefore towards the east, so India is located in the northeastern hemisphere. And as if like we are going to see of the Brazil too. If you are going to see the Brazil, for example, Brazil shape is as if like this way, a piece of lollipop as it seems. So Brazil is generally located, if you are going to see, an equator passes to the northern part of the Brazil, and the Tropic of Cancer goes as if like this way, and the globe is like this way, and the 0 degree prime meridian is over like here. So what we are going to see, how the difference is, 0 degree, Brazil is towards the left side. If you are going to see the left side of this, the left side is going to be the western hemisphere. West side is going to be the western hemisphere. And over the period of time, what we are going to see, western hemisphere and most of the part is lying below the equator. Most of the part of the Brazil is lying below the equator. Therefore, Brazil is located in southwestern hemisphere. Most of the part of the Brazil is located in the southwestern hemisphere. Most of the part of Brazil comes towards the southwestern hemisphere. Though equator passes to the northern part of the Brazil, there is some part lying over the, and above the, what you would say, the Brazil, northern part of Brazil, is somewhat as if like in the northern hemisphere, but 90% of the part, I would say, of the Brazil, 90 to 95% of the part of the Brazil is towards the southern hemisphere, and southern hemisphere is very much important for Brazil as far as the climatic factors of Brazil is concerned. Over the period of time, what we have studied till now, see, Brazil and India, differentiation. How differentiation? India is located above the equator, towards the right side, above the equator, towards the right side, northeastern hemisphere. Brazil is located towards the left side, so western and south, so it is located in the southwestern hemisphere. So we will study the exact latitude and longitudinal extent of India first, as we go. See, India is as if like this way, we are going to see, happening towards both the end, and a triangular kind of thing over here. So if we see, equator is passing just below India, but in equator is not passing from India, it is below our mainland. So what we are going to see, there are India and this is the mainland, and if you are going to see here, there are some islands in Andaman and Nicobar, okay. And there are some islands over here, and those islands are known as Lakshadweep Island. Island in the Arabian Seas are known as Lakshadweep Island, and islands of the Bay of Bengal is known as Andaman Nicobar Island. So what we are going to see, the southernmost tip of mainland. If we go with the southernmost tip of India with the mainland, then it is over here, Kanyakumari. And if we go with the southernmost tip of India, then it is over here in Andaman Nicobar, and it would be like 8 degree, it would be 6 degrees 45 minutes north. So southernmost tip of India is Indira Point. Note it down, southernmost tip. Indira Point. And the degree measures is 6 degrees 45 minutes north. And the mainland. Now we will start with the longitudinal and latitudinal extent. First of all, we will start with the latitudinal extent. Latitudinal extent is as in like this way. Latitudinal extent is as in like this way. So it is like 8 degrees 4 minutes. 84 and then here in the Gulf of near to Gujarat, it's like the standing line. Initially I said Letahua line is latitude. These are the latitude. Latitude goes with latitudinal extent we have completed. So it is like 8 degrees 4 minutes north to 37 degrees 6 minutes north. Now we will go with the longitudinal extent of India. Longitudinal extent of India goes with 786. How 786? We are going to see how India is differentiated. 786, we are going to see over here. 786 is as if like 7, 8 and 6. 68 degree 7 minutes eastern side. So it is eastern hemisphere. So this will be as if like 68 degree 7 minutes east towards the Gujarat, and here it end as it like this way, 84 376, and then 84 376, 786, and here 97 degree 25 minutes eastern hemisphere. Understanding everybody? So India's latitudinal latitudinal and longitudinal extent, southernmost tip of India, Indira Point, 6 degrees 45 minutes north. Mainland India, Kanyakumari is the southernmost tip of the mainland, and the official southernmost tip is Indira Point, 6 degrees 45. Latitudinal extent, we are going to see 8 degrees 4 minutes north to 37 degrees 6 minutes north. And longitudinal axis in the standing line view, we are going to see 87 degrees, means 786. In the reverse form, 786, 68 degrees 7 minutes east to 9725. So it will be better for you to understand if you chant like this way, 84376, 84376, and then 786 9725, 84376, then 786 9725. If you chant like this way, then you will be able to memorize it very sharply. And the southernmost tip, you have to remember Indira Point, and Indira Point is 6 degree 45 minutes north over the equator. Understanding everybody? And below the equator, it will be a south. And as India is located over the equator, therefore the latitudinal extent, we are going to see north, north and north. And the standing line, we are towards the right side of the 0 degree of prime meridian. So therefore, here east and here east. So it is very easy to understand Brazil and India. India, 84376 786 9725. Southernmost tip, Indira Point, 6 degree 45 minutes north. As Brazil, equator passed to the northern part of the Brazil, so here is the equator of 0 degree equator. As some part of the Brazil lies above the equator, so the latitude line, so latitudinal extent is like as if like 5 degree 15 minutes north. And the southernmost tip we are going to see of Brazil, southernmost tip of the Brazil, if you are going to see 5 degree 15 minutes north to 33 degree 45 minutes south. 5 degree 15 minutes north to 33 45 south. And then if you are going to see the longitudinal extent, if you are going in a western hemisphere, then we have to go from right to left. And in the eastern hemisphere, when you are measuring the longitude, then you have to go from left to right. And so that part, we have, if you are going to see the longitudinal extent is as if like 34 degree 47 west to here 73 degree 48 minutes west. So 5 degree 15 minutes north latitude to 33 45 south. And the latitudinal extent, if we have seen, 5 degree 15 minutes to 33 45, and the longitudinal extent is 34 47 to 73 48. 34 47 to 73 48. So this is the Brazil latitude and longitudinal extent. If you are going to see an important parallel of latitude of equator passing over here, and here if you are going to see a tropic of Capricorn passing, the angular measure, if you are going to see, is 23 degree 30 south. This is the tropic of Capricorn. So this is the Brazil difference between the latitudinal extent of Brazil and India. Brazil and India is differently located in different hemisphere. India northeastern hemisphere, Brazil southwestern hemisphere. India is having a particular season and Brazil is going to have particular season due to the longitudinal extent and hemispheral difference over the period of time. See, over the period of time, what we have studied, that India is located in the northeastern, Brazil is located in the southwestern. India's we have seen India got independent from the British in 1947. Similarly, Brazil got independence from the Portuguese in the year 1822. Over the period of time, India faced many financial crises over the period of time, if you are going to see, and Brazil also faced similar crises. India faced major war and they faced famine-like condition. Brazil faced famine condition over the period of time. And if you are going to see, there have been problem after independence. After Brazil got independence, it was under the populist military rule. So particularly democracy was not established. After the period of time, then the populist military was overthrown and the democracy was established. But in India, after 1947, total democratic process started and we had a republic government, and which is parliamentary and a prime minister is there. So over the period of time, this was the major part. And some more information of Brazil and India. If you are going to see in this chapter, objective are going to come from this chapter. Objective is as if like this way, which is this famous sport game in India. So if you are going to see famous, then it is cricket. And if it is like national, then it is hockey. Brazil, famous and national is, I would say, football. And over the period of time, India is famous. India is famous for spices, and Brazil is famous for coffee, because Brazil is known as the coffee pot of the world. And over the period of time, what we have experienced is that India is a major developing country. Brazil too is a major developing country, but over the period of time, India is looked upon as a big market and Brazil is looked upon as a future market, if you're going to see. And over the period of time, mostly the language spoken in India is Hindi, English and various regional language, and the language spoken in Brazil is majorly a Portuguese language is being spoken in Brazil. And over the period of time, and as if this chapter, we have seen that how Brazil and India is differently located and how location and extent differs between the India and between the Brazil. And end off for this chapter, and the notes will be provided, the soft copy will be given, and end of the thing.